Good evening, everybody. Good evening. Hey, Joelle, how are you?
Great, except my mic isn't over here.
Oh,
Great.
now you're doing good.
Yep.
Good. Like positioning, the difference between good and great. Just a little
Fantastic.
FYI there. FYI tip for all you podcasters out there. Anyway, my name is Jeff Gelman of Solid Canine Training. This is the lovely Joelle, and this is the What Would Jeff Do show, where we answer your dog training questions, and we give you as much helpful advice in the 15 seconds that I have to answer your question. Most people ask us, and if you just watch the cadence of the show, if you're brand new, you'll see that most people will ask us how to stop things. How do I stop? How do I stop? How do I stop? So you'll hear me often talk about apply a punisher, apply a correction, which are the exact same thing. I interchange the word punisher and correction, but the official word is to apply a punisher to instill an inhibitor to stop an unwanted behavior. That is the technical, real term for all you dog training aficionados out there. I also call shock collars, e-collars, and remote collars. They are all the same. So for all the trainers out there and the people arguing about, they're not called shock collars, it doesn't matter. We're talking about the same thing. E-collar technology, Dogtra, we're talking about the same thing. It's just, these are just semantics and people that like to argue and win and not like, nobody gives a shit. They really don't care. But the reason why I say that is because I want to give people some background and some context that when folks are want to train their dogs to do obedience, as we show in our Green to Graduate course, which Joelle will put up a link to the Green to Graduate
Green
course,
to graduate.
which is you can actually take a green dog, which means a dog that doesn't know anything, and technically no dog ever graduates training. It's a lifelong thing, which doesn't mean it's, hundreds of reps a day, but it's just a lifestyle. But at the beginning, you'll see in our Green to Graduate course where you can take a actually green dog to a fully off-leash trained dog.
If everybody did this course, we would have no more problems
We
in the
it'd
dog
be
world.
incredible. It would be we just came
All those
from,
off-leash dogs charging you
yeah,
wouldn't be a thing.
your dog would have recall even in drive. We show recall in drive with a high drive lab, very high drive lab. We do it. I've got a dog lying next to me right now, or two dogs, but Wes, he's half human because he belongs to Joelle. So he's gotten that way from all the affection and her treating him like a spouse. So he became a human.
He's the best dog ever.
I think it's important that folks understand. It's like, so we train with food. We train with positive reinforcements. We literally train with clickers. Like we train with classic positive reinforcements. We do luring. But everybody has a different bar. And then also everybody has a different arena. And there's the agility arena, which is a skill set I've got no idea how to. Kudos to agility trainers. They've got incredible skills. There are sport dog trainers. They have incredible skills. There are trick trainers. They have incredible skills. There are scent work people, nose work people. They have incredible skills. That's not my arena. I'm a family pet dog trainer. I specialize in stopping unwanted behaviors, but obviously I am fully capable of training a dog because that's usually part of the board and train program, what we do. But the reason why I do podcasts 6 times a week, I'm sorry, excuse me, 7 times a week, I podcast, and then I do a Zoom on Patreon, which is face to face, voice to voice, once a week. So it's 8 times a week I am available to all of you to ask your questions. And I don't really recall how to teach a downstay. And if because I'll just say, just watch our free video, or get the course, or do a consult. By the way, we do offer one-on-one consults. Now, one-on-one consults are powerful. A lot of people are like, no, you need to be hands-on with a dog. I've been doing this for 20 years, 10,000 dogs, 300 seminars, traveled the world, worked with every, I can't say every breed of dog, but like all different temperaments. a lot of leash reactivity, a lot of separation anxiety, a lot of dogs that are not all mentally there, high drive dogs, dogs that are unmotivated to work, dogs that are shut down, nervous and fearful. That's how they came in. So I have seen it all. I have seen it all. But most of the people ask how to stop things because nobody will give them the answer. 90% of dog trainers don't train bats. And people are like, oh no, really? Yeah. Bring your really badly, just bring a leash reactive dog to your average group class. Go to 5 different dog training schools that do group classes that are reward-based. They'll kick you out. They'll say, come back when your dog is better under control. Like, go to fat camp, be overweight. You can't enroll this year.
Where do you get these analogies?
You're too fat.
Where do you get this shit?
It's not like I said go to Masturbation Anonymous. Right?
You might as well have.
Well, I can give that example if you want me to as well. So ask your questions. On YouTube, we have something called Top Chat. And what that does is... lately it's been paying for our extra food bills at the grocery store. But what it does is it gets your question to the top of the queue. We answer it. A lot of people like to just throw us some cash because we've helped them over the years. We've rehabbed dogs just through the show, So imagine before we started doing online courses about 16 months ago, almost 20 years of just free videos. People have been rehabbing and training their dogs. Now we have online courses, which are just mind-blowing. Green to Graduate's my favorite. I really enjoy the latest 5-day. I enjoy the whole trifecta here. The 5-day e-collar course, which is about 10 hours, because it went over 5 days, live, unedited. Now you can just see the recording, but it's totally unedited. 2 hours of troubleshooting the following week, which was also unedited, and the go home. That was edited because we traveled around all over the place. And the go home is, that's what I wanted to ask you. What is the date that we're doing the emceeing of it?
24th at 6 p.m.
Can you explain how that's going to work?
Yeah. So you know how we pull up little things on here when you guys are watching the show? We're going to pull up the whole go home. Hour and a half of it, and then me and Jeff are going to be live, like emceeing it. So you can ask questions, we can pause it, be like, oh, rewind to that thing. You know what I mean? So we'll just be going over it live, so that you feel like you were there, and we can troubleshoot and like ask questions and expand on things as we go.
Right.
So that's going to be the benefit of coming to this course, because there is a live component to it where we can get deeper into concepts and things. Because everybody might think, okay, well, it's a finished dog, big deal, but there's a lot of things that go on at a go home session and things that even we overlook. As I was editing it, I was like, holy shit, like, I didn't realize that we got so much into this, and we really like Crystal and her husband learned a lot.
Yes.
A lot.
And they're knowledgeable.
They're experienced dog owners.
Yeah.
Little things. She's like, no one ever taught me that before. And so no one ever explained it that way before.
And so it's great for trainers to see how to interact and to
educate. But somebody even said that someone who's just a dog owner was like, holy shit, it helped me troubleshoot with my own dog.
Yeah, yeah.
So it's not just for perfectly finished dog. Like, no. Like, dog owners, trainers, you all benefit from this course.
And even if you have a perfect dog, dogs always eventually go bad. I mean, we've worked with...
Be a great refresher course.
We've worked with incredibly well-trained service dogs who were attacked by off-leash dogs, where all the training went out the window. And if we didn't rehab that dog would be washed. And that's an actual real service dog that they paid $25,000 for. They've owned for 3 years, and they actually need that dog to function in their daily life. And it was attacked by an off-leash dog. And it's like, if you don't rehab this dog, I've got to wash this dog and get another one.
Yeah.
And it's not like they get a refund.
No.
So it's like they got to spend another $25,000, get on a waiting list.
We work with so many dogs who are quote unquote finished.
Yes.
So there's always something to work on. Price is going to go up on the 20th. So take advantage of the pre-sale right now. It's $77.
Yep. And the link is up, Joel.
And the link is up. Yeah. But it's going to go up probably to like 99.
So let's get right into it right now. And as long as we don't go on a rant, we can try to keep this at an hour. It's a little bit freaky outside because it's light. So that's sort of weird. Yeah, I'm loving
it too. Although the mornings are fucking me up big time.
I've never seen you sleep so late.
I know.
It's Angelo.
Awful. Everybody's waking up late.
Angelo almost slept past school. I know. He almost missed school.
So bad.
Yeah.
Snuggle Buns. Hey, everyone. Scheduling a meet and greet with a four-month-old Papillon puppy. Hoping it goes well.
Oh, it'll go great. You'll do fine. Yeah.
Kim says, hi, Jeff and Joel.
Hey, Kim.
AV says, hi, guys.
Hey, how are you?
Hi. Caroline says, good evening.
Hey, AV. Is it AV or Avi? Mm-hmm.
Yes, which one?
So does it sound like it would start with avocado or aviator? Next.
Let's see. Two dogs and a dude. Yo. Snuggle Buns. Just went through the puppy course and have Green to Graduate to watch next. Awesome.
Nice. You're going to love Green to Graduate. So much, yeah. It literally is a game changer. It's so funny because, you know, today I did a bunch of consults and some of the consults were with fighting dogs. And I'm like, and not to say you could have a super obedient dog that they still fight. They're not connected. But what I do tell people is, well, we can't just sit around and wait till they fight. No. Let's up their training to a higher level. Let's hold them accountable. Let's change the dynamic of the way that they look at you. Mm-hmm. All right. Now they'll take you more seriously. Mm-hmm. And then your words mean more, but also the shrapnel effect might be like, we don't fight. It's all relationship. You change the relationship. We don't fight around
that person
anymore, which is usually like everybody I talked to today, the only fight when that person is present. It's multi-adult households. These dogs go to like grandma's house. These dogs go to daycare. These dogs go to boarding. These dogs are with their significant other. But they only fight with this person present and in the house. Hmm. One of them was in the house only.
Guarding.
You know, it was resource. Yeah, the resource guarding them. So, but I was like, okay, well, we'll set it up. So we did. We set up a bunch of protocols. But I said, let's also up their obedience. Next.
Yep. Naughty Boy Lon says, happy Wednesday evening. Let's see. Parker's Canine Academy. I train a lot of doodles. Once they learn to feel the e-collar, I notice some of them have a really busy mind, looking everywhere while staying in position while trying to pay attention. Mm-hmm.
So
I know exactly what you're talking
we
about.
We experienced it today because we actually made a video today. I'm sure Joelle's going to edit it. I'm not sure what my ramblings will turn into, but we're working with a dog who actually is a police dog failure, which means he's sound temperament and mind. He's non-aggressive. He actually knows his obedience, but he struggles with just holding command, and he struggles with slowing down his mind, which would be great for, you know, working dog. This dog was holding a downstay, but like whining and always looking around, and we're really good at stopping that, but he's definitely been a challenge.
Is that next?
Next, sorry.
Abby says, I agree. Two dogs and a dude. Vader is excited. 16 days and a wake up. Ah, till he's here training with us. Nice.
Oh, nice.
Can't wait. Abby says, Green to Graduate came off as a love-based method. Sometimes love hurts, but it's for the benefit of the ones you love. I love my dog, and your methods have improved our relationship. So thank you.
Yeah, you're welcome. I mean, this is the thing. It's like, you know, everybody has a perception of me is because of these shows that I'm like really harsh on dogs. Mm. But well, first of all, 99% of the dogs that come through our company, I don't touch. Most of them are trained up in Rhode Island, and I'm not there. So that's number one. And then also, but this concept is of harshness is always because people are asking me about some life and death stuff, and there's no time for that. But when you see like the e-collar course, I think the number one comment we got was, I can't believe how gentle you are. Mm-hmm. It's like, yeah, this is how we train. And when in Green to Graduate, you see it. But the whole tough love thing, that's like, That's all that is structure and boundaries. That's all that is. So I wouldn't even call it tough. I would just call it just training. I mean, if you want to change, you got to change.
Yeah.
You know, that's like saying, you know, I mean, getting physically fit. I'm in the gym 6 days a week, you know, compared to, you know, a couple of casual days a week. You got me hooked on legs. So now it's like I wasn't.
Oh, you're hooked on legs now?
I was hooked, not as an addicted, but I would say now I'm doing 3 days a week of legs.
Dang.
Like today was a heavy leg day. Heavy. Yeah. Yeah. Nice. I did 7 leg exercises today, including the playing card between the butt cheek one, which I do 3 times a week. Yeah. Yeah.
Good job.
Next.
Let's see. Jessica, my Aussie separation anxiety is solved to an outsider. No crate nonsense. She lays down, but she trembles and shakes. Her knees are worse and she pants, but she eventually falls asleep. She's highly trained. Suggestions.
Yeah, even if she was, there's untrained dogs that don't have separation anxiety, and there's highly trained dogs that do have separation anxiety. They're two separate things. One's state of mind, one's obedience. So, you know, the shaking and the panting, you can actually correct with a remote collar. And you're not going to hear that often.
It's not so much a correction, though. You're communicating with a remote collar, I would say.
It's usually above working level. It's what it is, though, is you can actually stop it. And what you're going to hear from a lot of people is, no, you can't. And all I'm going to say is, we do it all the time. So, yes, you can. Because I wouldn't say something that we haven't done a lot with success. And with success after they go home. Next.
Can you get my dog to stop chewing on his nuts? Wesley.
You want me to chew on them for them?
It's disgusting.
No, it's not.
I can't stand that sound.
Raise of hands, guys. Guys, if you could lick your balls, would you? I think so.
Disgusting.
Yes.
Let's see. Jessica also said it seems to come and go. And once it starts, I have to really work hard with her. She gets in a cycle.
If you got yourself a remote collar and just interrupted that. Boom. Interrupted it. All right. Next.
Avi says, to clarify, when I say love hurts, I mean it hurts me more than her when I have to correct, but it's necessary.
Well, sometimes. Agreed. I think a lot of times the benefit of a board and train is not that we're heartless because we love dogs. It's that we can remove ourselves emotionally and think logically, but we also have a job to do. Now, that doesn't mean we're uncaring and unloving. What it means, though, is we know that step 1, 2, 3 through whatever is the way that we're going to get a finished product, and we can't let our heart get in the way. And when you're doing rehab, as you know, you're doing it yourself, I think the biggest thing that stops people from success is their heart. And it makes sense because you love your dog. I get it. But if you talk to any family that has a drug addict as a child, at some point they actually have to kick them out of the house. They might have to put them into inpatient rehab. Stay away from Utah, please, for the inpatient rehab. And I think that it's not easy. With a dog, though, I would rather give my dog information that was seemed harsh for a few seconds and then live with a behavior that was dangerous or would be driving the dog crazy or driving us crazy for years. Next.
My gosh, he's breathing so heavy.
He's probably hot.
Crystal says yes to the kick out. So pure and positive, right? Can't stop reactivity, but sure as hell can kick the dog out. Kicking him out of class. I think you're talking about
that. Oh, got it. Yes. That's I know people that have showed up for a leash reactivity class. Like that is the class. It's not basic. It's not basic training 101. It's leash reactivity class. And they're like, you can't come. Your dog's too reactive. I'm like, you'd think if I had a dog that was that reactive, I'd be like, come on down, get the cameras on, because I'm going to show everybody and put it out there how you really stop a leash reactive dog. so everybody else can learn that doesn't have the finances or the logistics to get to us. And we actually have a leash reactive seminar video next.
Terry G said, LOL, the analogies are spot on. It's funny because it's true. Fat camp.
Next. Actually, I will say, though, small disclaimer on that one. People that do have gastric bypasses, some of them actually do have to lose weight.
Do.
Before
doctors
want to
know
before because they're too big.
They want them to put in the effort too.
But it's not even the effort. It's like you're actually it's too dangerous. Also, you have to get a psych exam as well. Mm-hmm. So there are some, but usually if you can make it to fat camp, you're not in that category because that means you got to get up off your couch and move. Yeah.
Crixis, I've been following for a long time. That Coco Goes Home video was a game changer. Learned a lot from a different perspective. Awesome job, guys. Owners were awesome, too.
Good. I think you priced that really well, too.
Yeah. I think some people got a sneak peek today on YouTube.
Yeah.
Because Jeff accidentally made it live, even though it's a course. So if you watched it between midnight and noon today, you got a freebie. But you don't get to attend the live if you watch it on YouTube. Sorry. But yes, we got a lot of good feedback on that. I'm actually going to take a little screenshot of that, Crixis. I'm glad you enjoyed it.
Good. That's very informative.
I think so. Honestly, I was editing it. I was like, damn. I didn't even catch myself saying that. Or like something you said. I'm like, oh, that's a little nugget. Because I've never really recorded a go-home from start to finish I'll grab the highlight reels.
How many go-homes have we done?
Like so many.
Like we don't, you know, it's almost like,
it's like second nature.
Yeah. It's sort of like, you know, why do you think pilots do checklists? You know what I mean? The co-pilot does the checklist, you know, this, because they've done so many things that they just do a lot of things by second nature, but that's also how it's easy to actually make a mistake too. So they've got to like go through the lists, you know.
Sawblade, I've been approved for 9-week old Aussie cattle dog blue heeler mix. I picked the puppy up Saturday, already rewatching the puppy course.
Good. Yeah.
That's awesome.
Yeah. Puppies can be interesting because there's a little bit of, you know, you never know. I mean, the biggest thing is, you know, immediately stop the biting, stop the jumping, stop the whining, stop the barking. And then hopefully we got some food drive and just use their daily food. Just use their daily kibble if they're on kibble or their whatever they're on. Most of them are on kibble as training. Don't let them eat out of a bowl. And it's not because I'm not like this whole hand feeding thing. That's the wrong dog. No.
He's always trying to go to the other bed.
It's probably because it's bigger. This is a small bed. It's also falling halfway off the couch. Next.
Kim, I love how you guys keep it fresh. You are never stale. No matter how many times I watch your podcast, it's a no-nonsense approach. Desensitize versus distract. Push the threshold versus redirect. What a concept. Instead of brainwashing your dog, allow them to be a part of the process.
Yeah, I mean, obviously we do reps. We do reps. But the last thing we want to do is turn it into a choreographed routine because we actually want to teach the dog how to think, teach the dog how to make better choices, teach the dog what the words actually mean. So we actually get to the point once the dog has all of the, and we show this a lot. I showed it in yesterday's Instagram stories with Bruno. I'm actually confusing him on purpose by doing a series of obedience things in different orders. And he's got to make a decision. Do I go right or do I go left? Because one way is the crate, one way is the place bed, and I don't move and I don't give any cue whatsoever. I'm just using my words. So he has to really, really think. And you can see his mind thinking. So it's really great. And I documented all that for, and if you're an Instagram subscriber, I documented that for you. Next.
Avi said, I learned a lot from the go home, but I'm not sure I can spend right now. Will it be available for a while?
It will. I think the price will be up.
Price will go up, but it'll probably be up there, yeah.
I'm sure eventually they might bundle it, you know, but still then it'll even be more, you know, because it'll be all three of them. But the price will probably go up a little bit. Hold on one second. Let me just talk.
I have a hard time.
He's falling.
I know, he's pushed his bed off the stairs. There you go, Bruno.
There we go. Now we won't get off anymore. Okay.
There we go.
Yeah, we'll probably sell the bundle for the e-collar, troubleshooting, and go home. But the prices on everything have gone up.
Yeah.
So you really got the best deal if you attend
yeah.
live.
Yeah, you can blame Biden for that, by the way. Yeah.
It's true.
It is.
It's true, man. Someone's going to pay for our groceries.
It's true.
Shit.
It's true.
Everything's like,
why did the courses go up? Biden. Next.
Why did everything go up?
Yep.
Enjoy the journey, dog training. Howdy, howdy from cloudy Arizona. So grateful for really? Your workshops to see trainer and owner perspectives to make it easier on everyone.
Is there such a thing as cloudy Arizona?
Today was like the first cloudy day we've had.
But we're in Florida.
I was so sad.
Arizona's
Why
different.
Why the hell is it cloudy out?
It started out.
It was like dark as hell at 9 o'clock.
When I went to the gym this morning, it was cold. I put the heated seats on.
Yeah, it was really cold today. But now it's hot again. It was like 5 hours.
Meanwhile, they projected a hot of 69 and it was 82.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They couldn't be more wrong if they yes. tried. They're like, fuck it. Let's just see how wrong we can be so that people are actually happy.
Well, tomorrow's supposed to be really warm because Angela's friend and him, they're coming over to swim. So hopefully it'll be nice and warm. Yeah.
Avi, the second one, avocado.
Avi, okay. Ava. So it's
It's A-V-I.
Right.
Avi.
Right.
I don't think it's Ava.
That's how you pronounce avocado.
Like the A. Ah.
Ah.
You
okay.
said aviator or avocado.
Oh, Ava. Got it. Got it.
Avi.
Got it.
Lindsay. I have a Labrador retriever that walks beautifully on a prong, but he's going to do the American temperament test next week and can't wear any training tools.
Nope.
Is there any tricks to get him to walk okay on a leash without any training tools?
Sure.
Yes.
Yes. Yeah.
We literally just did a walking masterclass. Granted, we teach it with tools, but we teach you how to eventually get off the tools in the walking class.
Right.
Let me find it. Give me 1 second and I'll link it.
But you know, that's so this is the thing. I'm glad you're taking the class, but don't let that be the end of your journey.
I also specifically talk about that in the course because you need to train the dog what heel is, just like any other obedience command. I think a lot of people rely too much on the prong collar, and then the dog only will walk good if the prong collar is on. So in this class, the Mastering the Walk class, we talk about that and how to phase it out.
Yeah.
Let's see.
But that doesn't mean you've got to get off tools. Like,
no.
Yeah.
We're super pro tool, but your dog should be able to walk on just a slip.
Well, it should be able to walk off leash next to you. I mean, but this is the thing though. We just want to make people's lives easier. Mm-hmm. That's all we want to do. And a lot of people are like, you know, how long does the dog have to wear the prong collar for? And I'm like, would you say that about a martingale?
Right.
Would you say that about a front clip harness?
The leash itself?
Would you say that about a head halter?
Why can't I get rid of this leash?
Right. And it's like,
I ask myself that. I fucking hate
So it's like, I mean, it was like, well, I live in there's leash laws. And I'm like, I know there's leash laws. And that doesn't mean like there's plenty of places you can go.
We saw our first responsible dog owner at the park today. I couldn't believe it. I should have got it on camera.
Who?
When we were like, the dog's off leash, we're all like
panicking. He put a slip lead on.
And then he put a slip lead on his dog and politely walked
it by.
I couldn't believe it. I couldn't believe it.
We were not all panicking.
I was. Okay, that's, I was like, great, another freaking off-leash dog is going to charge us. I couldn't believe it. I should have went over there and personally thanked him. Holy shit. Lindsay. I already read that. Enjoy the journey. I learned how to lure a tiny dog under my legs from Q&A you did several years ago.
Yep.
So you do teach how to do stuff. Ha ha. Thanks so much.
Yeah, we do.
See?
Yes, we do. We have a lot of tricks up our sleeve.
Yep.
Especially for dogs that, you know, don't want to do it.
Down.
Down is actually the people struggle with it. Down. Dogs struggle with down.
Susie, now that you both moved to Florida, did your furry babies come with you?
No, just our dogs and Angelo.
They've been here though.
Yeah, sorry, we don't call them furry babies. Sorry, no jab at you, but our dogs, they're here, and I lost one since I've been here. Girl passed.
Last July.
Oh yeah, was it really? Yeah, girl passed, and so we're down to two, one apiece. Yeah, Next.
Dan, really contemplating on getting into dog training. Wish I could do the master class this year, but not in the cards. Any other resources you recommend to check out to get started? Doing Green to Graduate with a new 14-week puppy to see how I do on my own with your course and guidance, of course.
Yeah, I think keep in mind, you know, if you just look around your neighborhood, you know, just watch dogs just walk down your street. Who said that?
Dan.
So number one, I do mentoring, but if you don't want to pay for that, don't pay for that. But I do it. It's the same as my consulting fee that's available on the Academy. I do one-on-one. So you can talk about anything you want to. Social media, Joelle will do it. Business, I'll do it. Dog training, I'll do it. But just look at the dogs that are at your local park. Look at your dogs that are walking down the streets. And what's everybody struggling with? Pulling dogs. Leash reactivity. Mm-hmm. When you go to people's houses that have dogs, what happens? They jump on you. They don't listen to owners. They bark out windows. So stay away from aggression. But it's like the majority of our clients could get paid to train dogs for way more than 50% of the dogs out there.
Oh, yeah.
A very good amount of the dogs out there, though. Because most people just what? We're pet dog trainers. So most people and most dogs out there are family pets. The majority of them are, you know. So that's why when people are like, you know, they're banning e-cowers, you know, they want to ban them in, say, California, except for canines, you know, it's like, how many working canines are there in California compared to, like, you know?
There's going to be none soon.
Family pets. It's
are
like,
they, like, not allowed to do anything?
They're trying to pass. They can't bite.
So what's the point of having it?
They can't bite. Well, they're going to end up with a lot of dead dogs.
It's like, okay, they can sniff stuff out, but their main goal is to, like, take down
criminals. Their main goal is to inflict pain to stop a threat. And I know many canine officers and their lives have been saved, not just their lives, but the lives of backup, but especially the handler's life has been saved by the dog because it does bite things. And it gets to the point then where the bad person can be neutralized. So this, I just mentioned this because it's going on in your community and it's affecting every part of animals. And it's all under the guise of animal welfare, but it's not. It's not. That's like saying masking is under the guise of public health. No, it's not. It's under control. Next.
Sid, evening J&J, overslept too, off schedule.
Yeah. Everybody's mucked up.
Yeah. Parker's Canine Academy. Is there anything I can do or is it just how his mind is? What do you call that dog? Doodle.
I would say just tape a picture of your baby on, like, on a stick in front of your dog. She's the one that had the baby, right? Parker's?
No, I don't think so.
Oh, is there anything you can do? What's the dog doing?
Scanning a lot. Like,
okay.
You know what doodles do? They look around.
Forget the baby part. Yes. What you can do is you can do a leash pop or a remote stim. Yep.
Yeah, you can stop all that scanning.
Yep.
Terry G, I've watched Green to Graduate several times. It seems like I always find something new that I miss or forgotten about.
Yeah.
The replays are great to have.
Yeah.
They're yours for life. And guess what? Any updates we make, you get those.
Well, there's a small disclaimer there. They're only good for 300 months.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. 25 years.
25 years.
Yeah. That's it. That's the most you can do.
Sorry.
Isn't that weird?
Yeah. Didn't let me go anymore.
Like, how did they decide that?
Because they're probably like, maybe our website won't be around from then. Who knows?
300 episodes, 300 months.
300 months.
Months, yeah. So.
For life.
Yeah, yeah. It's sort of like this. I've read books. I'm listening to an audio book for the second time in a row. I'm listening to, people always ask me, like, what books, what's on my playlist. I'm listening to, Ed Milet, The Power of One More. And right before that, I'm listening to that for the second time. And right before that, I listened to Your Next Five Moves by Patrick Bet-David twice. and I hear things differently, and I listen to it I'll probably listen to each one of my audio books. I usually listen to at least 6 times, and I always pick up something new. I mean, I've listened to like Jim Rohn, 25 times, and you pick up something new each time. Oh yeah. Yeah. I mean, I go back to that one a lot. Yeah. Yeah.
Two dogs and a dude. Jeff's truth is harsh, but his love for dogs and their owners is obvious.
Why do we keep saying harsh?
Your truth is harsh. It is. You're a straight shooter.
Yeah.
Today, telling the truth is harsh. Okay. Most people like cry when they hear the truth. So people can't handle. You can't handle the truth.
That is so fucking applicable right now.
Isn't it?
People are avoiding the truth.
They want to live in their like fantasy world.
They're like, hold on here. Where's the closest safe space? Oh, it's only 20 feet away. I can tell the truth. Because then they can run to the safe space. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? So yeah. Next.
3, 2, 1 and me. I made my first bonker this morning and made my partner watch your YouTube video on YouTube. Already making a difference that we both noticed.
Nice.
Made him watch the video.
Wow.
Make him do it.
Damn. That's like some couples communication going on there.
I know.
Yeah.
Healthy relationships. Yep. Daniel, hi, how are you today? Good morning from New Zealand. Love you.
Hey, Daniel. Love you too, buddy. Hey, Daniel, man. I love your enthusiasm.
I know. All the sunshine emojis.
I love the fact that you're showing up all the way from New Zealand. That's great.
Jessica, I would like to go to New Zealand. It's the one thing I struggle with, and it's frustrating me so much. I'm feeling so overwhelmed by it and pisses me off because it's not rocket science. I'll have to try different remote levels. The separation anxiety.
Yeah, separation anxiety actually is not easy.
It's not.
Now, I would say that 95%, I used to say 99, but we're getting a lot more dogs that are not put together. About 95% of the dogs that come in, we eliminate separation anxiety in 1 to 2 nights. But we are seeing more and more dogs that are absolutely struggling with separation anxiety. And we are seeing a ton of dogs. I would say the majority, which means more than 50%, the majority of dogs are coming in absolutely not
together
with all their faculties. Yeah.
All their faculties.
Yes.
Terry G, if I had balls, no, I wouldn't. She would not lick her own
but
balls.
But Terry G, you don't have them, so you don't know.
No one should want to lick their own genitalia.
Okay.
What's that guy? Manson. Took his ribs out or whatever. Is that real? Was that like true? Or is that just like
to blow himself?
Is that just like the rumor that went around? Who knows?
There's a ton of Hollywood. I have a feeling there's a bunch of false information out there about Marilyn Manson. It's funny because I actually know Dita, so it's funny.
Do you?
Dita Bonte? Yeah, I knew her back pre-Dita. Mm. Yeah, back. Oh geez, 30 years ago.
Ooh, Tex is going off on something.
Someone's going after the chickens.
Something's in the yard trying to get on chickens.
Yep, he's good.
Look, he's on it.
Yep,
he's such a good guardian.
Yep.
Montag, hey Jeff, how do you introduce e-collar for separation anxiety? Crate corrections. Damn, we need to make a course on separation anxiety.
There's a lot of moving parts. You set it up, you have a video camera, you get out of the room, and you're going to be going up and down the dial, sometimes momentary, sometimes continuous, all various numbers, and you read the dog. If Jeff, how do you do a downstay? I can give you a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You know what I mean? Separation anxiety though, first of all, there's so many levels of it, from just whining, barking in the crate to totally breaking out, breaking your teeth out, breaking off toenails. There's all kinds of different levels of it. So that's something that would be good for a one-on-one consult. Next.
Snugglebun said, I was wondering about that Coco Go Home video. I paid for the course and I thought it was great to see, especially the public access.
Yeah, that was a mistake I made. And Joelle is rubbing
it. Never live it down.
Great.
I'll remind him every day.
And I apologized.
I'll leave sticky notes everywhere.
And I apologized and I felt
bad. Oh my God, relax. Because guess what? Even though if you watch it on YouTube, you still don't get the live part. So I think that's worth it in itself.
We're actually gonna have a party. I was actually like getting more content up on shorts and I made a mistake.
That's all right. Everyone got a little teaser.
Yeah.
Two dogs and a dude. One of the hardest parts for me with Vader is he knows the commands, but his moments of SGD suddenly gone deaf syndrome, then I get mad. But after you told me you have had to let go of people for getting mad, I've made a conscious effort to stay calm even when he pisses me off. Yeah, you cannot bring emotions.
Just use the remote collar. That's the best thing to get through sudden death syndrome. Sudden death remotes don't work. Maybe it starts their heart again, but I don't know.
You can't be angry though. And I think honestly, the lack of tools and lack of clear communication is what causes a lot of anger.
I think I have seen people who are against tools and
they yell at their dog.
They're physical with their dog. They pick up the dog by the leash, yank the dog up by the collar. I've seen a lot of people be way more physical with, and I'm not talking aggression. I'm just talking about their dog because they haven't put in a good enough baseline on it. Next.
Abby, Brandon is why I can't afford to go home. I just went food shopping and thanked him good at the register, laughing my ass off.
Do you thank him or you said this is fucking bullshit?
Probably the latter.
Right, right.
Ugh, snuggle buns. If I do end up getting the Papillon, what is going to be the safest collar for her? I'm worried about the smaller breed's propensity for collapsed trachea.
Well, then don't do a flat buckle collar. Don't do a martingale and don't do a slip lead. Believe it or not, a micro prong collar is the safest collar.
Who makes the tiny ones?
You can get them from
what's the name of that place?
Kirkland.
They make a little teeny tiny.
Yes. They're American made. Tell them I sent you.
Lisa, my pup is refusing to down. I cannot lure her and she's super food motivated. Never had an issue before. We'll get there though.
How much does your dog understand leash pressure? Do you understand leash pressure? Do you know how to do leash pressure down? A lot of force.
How many leash pressures are you going to say in one sentence?
I haven't said leash pressure once.
Yeah. You did.
When have I said leash pressure?
Please. Did your dog understand leash pressure?
I never say leash.
Do you understand
leash pressure? I never say.
Do you know how to teach a leash pressure?
I never say leash pressure on a show. Never. If I said leash pressure once. Next.
Try the leash.
Yeah.
Or just
try leash pressure, actually. Next.
Kimba says, love valuetainment.
Oh, yeah. And they're in Florida.
What's valuetainment?
That's his company.
Who?
Patrick's company.
Who's Patrick? Did I miss something here?
Patrick Bet-David's company.
When did you talk about that on this show?
An audiobook that I was listening to for the second time. So he came from Iran at 5 years old, didn't know a word of English. Mm. And he's got a company. He just bought a humongous complex in Florida and he's actually looking for talent.
You should go on his show.
Not his show. He's actually looking for talent for other shows. Mm. But he is, he's a wonderful interviewer. A wonderful, rational interviewer. And he's got an incredible mind. And the way that he communicates in business and with guests and just with everything is just really, really inspiring. Next.
Curations. Hey, guys, not a big problem, but my dog struggles coming out of a down position and into a sit position. I usually have to either tell him twice or correction or just stare at him for him to sit.
That's not the worst thing. What you do is grab the leash, walk if they're, you know, their paws are like this, walk between their, if you've got a food motivated dog, walk between their paws, hold the food up. What is this important phone call?
I know they like won't stop.
And it's a nine. It's a Florida number. Whenever anybody calls from Bradenton, I'm like, should I pick it up or not? I don't pick up my phone. Because I've got
four. Is it the third time they've called?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I don't want to do it in the middle of a podcast, but it could be important though. Hmm. Yeah.
Let's see. Curations. I already read that. Did you answer that?
So leash, walk food, walk between their legs.
Use like spatial pressure.
Hold up the leash, and then give them the food lure at the top and just say, you know, sit, and then just practice doing your puppy push-ups.
Kim said, the truth is the truth, believe it or not.
The truth is the truth. Opinions are opinions. Facts are facts. It's very important that people understand that. So if your feelings are...
people would understand that by now.
Yeah.
Like it's 2023.
Right. There are facts out there. There are facts.
But they just get changed on the daily. So right. There's really like not anymore.
Right. Like there's a video out there of someone, I don't know who it is, I never met this person, screaming and yelling and going ballistic that we teach double down by blasting dogs at 100. And they took the time out of their very, very busy day to make a video blasting Jeff Gelman. There's so many hate videos out there about me, which is fine. I find it comical. Sometimes it actually gives me inspiration to create content. They're like, that fucking asshole Gelman, he blasts dogs at 100 and can make them do a double down. Ironically,
in what world did that work?
Ironically, I actually have a how to do a double down video that we actually made, and it's live, and I show how to do it, and it's all low levels. I've also shown it at I do it at seminars, all low levels. So I'm not quite sure where that started circulating. But I've also heard that if a dog doesn't do a downstay, I choke it out. Like there's people that are saying there's stuff like that out there too. There's all kinds of nonsense out there. There's like bonkers are filled with metal pipes, you know, frozen water bottles. And I'm like, it's a $1.39 soft towel from Walmart. And that's it. Next.
Curations, dude, these two dogs itching over here, they're like freaking thing one and thing two. Chill out, guys. All right, Curations. By the way, thanks for all the help and watching a lot of videos and really been enjoying them. Thanks for everything.
Nice.
Snuggle Bun said, thank you. I was looking at those. Constance, Joelle, as you said that about Marilyn, I asked my husband if it was urban legend. So Jinx, I don't know.
About what?
Nobody knows about Marilyn Manson.
Oh,
it's Hollywood. You'll never know.
You'll never know.
Sid, telling truth, lost the old friend because I refused to board her dogs. They eat their shit, bark nonstop, pull on leash. And she said, no corrections. I told her, I don't operate that
way. Yeah. Then let her go somewhere else. Yeah. I mean, it's like, and if you lost a friend because that's not a friend. No, it's like, no. Sorry. Like, how about this? Would you like, you know, hey, can you babysit my kid? You know what they have the habit of? They open up all of your, you know, your grandmother's china that you like so much. You know what they love to do? They love to open up cabinets and throw dishes on the floor and break them. And then you know what? They don't know how to use a toilet yet, so they'll shit all over your house. Can you watch my kid for the weekend? Like, I mean, no. I mean, it's like, so it's called lack of accountability. It's called not taking 100% responsibility for your actions or the actions of your dogs. But it's like, no. And if you're going to lose a friend because of that wasn't a friend. That's not a friend, okay? It's an asshole in disguise.
It's a good one. It's an asshole in disguise. I love it.
Next.
Let's see. Two dogs and a dude. Vader crouches in the elevator like something is going to eat him when the door opens and blows through NCS of 100+ and won't move.
Yeah.
Damn, how well we practice elevators.
This is what you do. You do elevator drills.
Well, he sent a dog to us. He probably wants us to do the damn elevator drills.
Well, don't blast him. Do me a favor, Vader. Stop with the correcting of that. Stop correcting at all.
Yeah.
You don't need to correct at all. What you just need to do is you need to, that would be a counter conditioning protocol. That would be leash pressure and an upward movement. I would practice with that dog doing sits, downs, and stands in the elevator. I tend to go into the elevator and go to the left. Because by nature, most people go to the right. So I go to the left and I usually put my dog between the wall and me. So it's a buffer because people want to come in. They'll want to pet the dog or they've got a dog and I want to be able to block. And my dog doesn't have problems with elevators. But what I would do is I would stop the correcting.
Yeah. Let's see. Snuggle Buns. Oh, Constance said, I use Kimberland and Micro Prongs on my Frenchies.
Oh, there you go.
Their buckle release is nice. I recommend.
There you go. Well, if Constant uses them, you know it's right.
Magic Beans. What can I do to get my two-year-old Pitbull to chill out? She also smothers guests.
Magic Beans, welcome to the show. I don't think we've seen you here before. No. So you're brand new to the show. So first of all, smothers guests. Number one, we're going to leverage obedience to stop in unwanted behavior. So there's something called the place command. The place command is have your dog go to a dog bed and stay there. And they can stay there the whole time the guest is over. I've got free videos on YouTube on how to get that. Also, when there's eventually, once they know what to do, you can actually correct, or even if they don't know what to do, but keep them on a leash when guests come over. They go to some other guests, you say no and give the dog a firm leash pop. Having a prong collar on, that's going to be a punitive-based answer to that. So teach the dog that smothering guests is inappropriate. What was the first thing that they're struggling with, though?
Needs it to chill out.
So then what you're doing is when the dog is in, here we go. Hold on 1 second. They're black dogs. So dog one, dog two.
Laying down. Chilling.
That's what you want.
But if okay. He said B-R-E-A-K, they'd be run around.
Those are both high drive working line German Shepherds that are not tired. They're not tired at all. Those are those kind of dogs that can go for like 24-hour marathons. Next.
Sid, exactly, Jeff. She's ridiculous. She then bullied me for 2 weeks, so I banned her.
Good.
Hi, Felicia.
Yep. Yep.
Becky, good evening, you two. Always like to listen and stay on top of things. I own Green to Graduate and the e-collar course.
Nice.
Work in progress. Have to work better on in-home behavior. My cockers are leash reactive.
Yeah, you probably should get the leash reactive. Yeah. Not to get you to spend more money, Becky, but the leash reactivity course, I would get the one that's the least expensive one. The one that's the full day of the seminar. That's a really, really good one. You can have a perfect heel, but still have a leash reactive dog. A lot of people with leash reactive dogs are told to tighten up the heel. Now, absolutely, you should have a good heel, but that's not going to stop leash reactivity. It just won't. So you have to address leash reactivity, separately. Next.
Let's see. Sid said, emotional illness in display, sadly, has other issues.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, just have empathy. That's all you can do, Sid, is just have empathy, which is what I do with, I have empathy for people. I don't have hatred in my heart. I just have empathy. Yeah.
Magic Beans, and thanks so much.
You're welcome, Magic Beans. And welcome to the show. And we do this podcast twice a week, the Q&A. And it's like this. I mean, technically,
hopefully we don't scare you away.
Technically, Magic Beans, we need to talk for hours. What I mean? But what I would do is I would get the Green to Graduate course, because it's going to show you how to fully train your dog. And that's going to help you with all of your in-house Everything. And out-of-house stuff. That's going to teach you a lot of our philosophies. But and then I do a Monday through Friday 8 a.m. podcast called Wake the Fuck Up with Jeff, and we've got that going. And then I've got a Patreon channel, which is $10 a month. There's a Q&A on there as well, so lots of either free or low cost solutions for your answer. But I would suggest the Green to Graduate course, which it's $197, but it's cheaper than a consult trainer. For me, and it's cheaper than a dog trainer. Next.
Most people are fully off leash training their dogs for like under $500 with us.
Oh, it's crazy. Even less than that. But yeah, sometimes they need like one,
maybe a consult.
One consult just to tune some things up. Yeah. Yeah.
Crazy.
Yeah.
Two dogs and a dude. I stopped after it didn't work, then booked with you.
Yeah. Thanks.
Kimba, I wanted to sign up for the Mastering the Walk online. Was there a bundle with beginning e-collar too, or am I mistaken? You were talking about price changes, so maybe you covered it already.
The Green to Graduate has the Mastering the Walk in it.
No, it does not.
Oh, the new one. Oh, the new Mastering the Walk. Oh, that's the Walk the Walk. Sorry. Walk the Walk. Sorry, sorry, sorry.
The e-collar Mastering the Walk is a totally separate course.
Yes, it is. It's just recent. We just filmed it. Along with
the beginning e-collar 5-day.
And
there's no bundle yet.
No bundle yet.
Yet. So I'm going to talk to Tony. That's all like logistics on his side. He puts that all together.
Yes.
But yeah, we'll have one out soon. We'll probably send out an email that we put it in a bundle. Snugglebun said Patreon Q&As are great. Learn so much sitting in on them.
Good. Snuggle Buns, you don't participate though, do you? What's your real name? Do you participate in those, or are you just a stalker? There's a lot of lurkers out there, but they don't even turn their cameras on, and it says their name is like iPhone 2. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. It's like, so there's a lot of people hiding from me.
Are you recording those yet?
No.
Why not?
Because I didn't take a poll yet and see how everyone felt about that.
Okay. Yeah. It's going to stay in Patreon, so.
Nothing on the internet stays private.
All right.
Remember that.
She said, not yet, just a lurker so far. My name is, is it Carrie or like
Kate? It's not Kira.
It's not Kira.
No.
Carrie, I'm assuming.
I don't know, but I think your parents just wanted to fuck with you later
in life. Give us what is it, photonics?
I think your parents just wanted to fuck with you later in life is what I think.
Is it phonetics? Where you pronounce that?
You know what I? You know who I met the other day?
Who?
They asked me at the what's your name? And I'm like Jeff, and they're like, is that a G or a J? And I'm like, it's with a J. I mean, how many G's?
G E O F F.
Yeah, I said, how many G Jeffs do you meet? And she's like, well, my name is Jess.
With a G.
No, it
isn't.
Yes. And I said, man, your folks really wanted, yes, you really wanted to fuck things up for you later in life.
Wow.
Yeah.
Kiri. K-E-E-R. Okay, Kiri.
It is Kiri. Okay, it is Kiri. Yeah. Yeah.
All right.
Look at what Wes is like. I mean, I'm sorry, but Tex
is on the problem.
Tex is like, don't fuck with my chickens. Uh-uh. He's like the best chicken defense system we have.
He is. Nothing comes in the yard.
Yeah.
Nothing.
He really is.
One night, this poor possum though was walking along the fence, and he was like jumping, trying to eat.
Oh yeah, that possum was frozen.
Poor thing.
And it was trying to get back to its home. Yeah, it did. We called him off, and then you sent Wes.
I didn't send Wes. I wanted the poor thing to freaking just hustle. I don't mind possums; they kill the bugs.
Yeah.
Constance said, I lurk on the Patreon Q&As. I also like the privacy of the Q&As because it's a small group of like-minded people where you can say and ask anything without judgment.
That's why I don't want to record them. That's why. Yes, because there's just literally, she summed it all up. That is why I don't want to record them. Yeah.
All right. That's it anyway. It's 6:58.
So, Kimberland makes microprongs. Kirkland is Costco. Yes.
Oh, yeah. Did we both say Kirkland?
Yes.
We spent way too much time at Costco.
It's true.
That's hilarious.
In fact, for dinner tonight, you had their smoked salmon.
I feel like we do that a lot too. Kimberlyn and Kirkland.
Were we talking Costco language? Right, it's like, hey, our Q&As are free, but you have to watch them. Everyone's every like, week. But
I don't know
every,
about that other brand.
You gotta watch them every week.
It's like, you need an off-brand prong call. Go to Costco.
Go to Costco.
Kirkland, so funny.
Yeah.
Oh, all right, last one. Stop people from petting my dog without asking me. Good luck with that.
Well, this is what you do.
You have to get really.
Is that what's
real quick.
What? Her name is the middle.
Holly.
So Holly. Holly, let me ask you a serious question. Am I allowed to walk up to you and touch your boobs? Seriously, am I? What would you do if I tried to? Would you let me?
You break your glasses.
Right. Kick me to knee to the balls, palm to the nose. Got it? Correct? So you do have, it's about, what it is a boundary issue, Holly. A lot of people struggle with boundaries. So, but you, a lot of people say, oh, I struggle with boundaries. And I'm like, no, you don't. And because it's a lot of females that are like this. And I'm like, you don't struggle with boundaries at all. Like you would not allow me to walk up to you and just touch you. Well, the hell if you're, and they're like, no, I wouldn't. I'm like, so you do have boundaries. So you need to put the dog petting, the random dog people petting your dog into that same boundary box as one more thing you don't allow people to do. So that doesn't mean you knee them in the nuts or the crotch and smash them in the nose if they try to pet your dog, unless one hand's down, one hand's up, you know, then you do. But what you do is, unfortunately, you can always say, you know, please don't do that, but be really quick to then go, you know, more forceful. I unfortunately rarely find by being polite in that situation works. So I've got to be pretty forceful with that.
Speaking of Costco, I'm surprised they haven't come out with like their own dog training thing yet. You know how Costco, you can get like everything, solar, vacations.
What do you mean on the way out?
Need your dog trained? Kirkland dog training.
Well, Amazon's going to.
Amazon's going to train your dogs?
So the reason why Amazon started the whole Amazon lock so the delivery people can actually put their packages inside your house.
Yeah.
They can also put away your groceries. Mm. And it's all, it comes with a camera so you can see.
Oh, I see. Okay. So all these out of control dogs that are biting people.
No. They what they wanted to do was Amazon is, they started, actually I remember when Jeff started the company, Mr. Bezos started the company. Now obviously they do everything, but they're like, they deliver to the house. They're like, how can we get into people's houses? Not to do anything nefarious, but it's like, so we can offer cleaning services, plumbing services, electrical services, dog sitting services, delivering of grocery services into your fridge and freezer. Let's install a camera right at the front door. Let's put our own locks, keypad locks that are only work each time once. Mm-hmm. So you get a special, this delivery is coming. Well, you have this code. Oh, you're going to be cleaning the house today. You have this code. Mm-hmm. They wanted to be able to get into the house to be able to offer more, as many services as possible.
Okay.
It's sort of like Coca-Cola. They're not competing with other sodas. They're competing with anybody that quenches your thirst. Yes.
Any thirst quencher.
Yes.
Paul, you said, thanks for that advice. I think because I'm early 20s, people don't take it seriously when I say they can't pet my dog. And then they complain when my dog snaps at them.
So
don't let the dog snap at them. You snap at them.
You snap at them.
Bitch slap them so
That's
hard.
Right. Who snaps first? You or the
Who's
dog?
Who's going to snap first,
Holly? We want Holly. Holly,
do it.
Holly the snapper. Snap, snap, snap.
Just bite. Go like this.
That's
like,
right.
Try to bite them when they.
That's right. Just say, Holly, Holly, get a t-shirt that say, I'm a snapping bitch. All right. Get the t-shirt. And everyone's
dog doesn't bite. I do.
That's right. That's right. My dog's a princess. I'm the bitch.
Right? That's right.
All right. And I say that in a respectful way, obviously. All right. Madly in love with all of you. We will see you on Friday. I will see the rest of you tomorrow morning, 8 a.m. Eastern Standard Time.
Friday show.
Oh, you will see Angelo is going to be my co-host. Yep.